Battlefield. Fox Puff. See what they can do. Just, did Olo always play the Flower Puff? I thought he was a, I thought he was a Headband Puff, but maybe not. Burgard, spacing a lot nicer this set. I immediately noticed that. Definitely, treating Aldo with a little more precaution, maybe, than he was treating Abzera. More patient right from the beginning. Playing a much more, like, cut-and-paste Puff Fox matchup here. Just like that. Just, oh. Probably one more back air from ledge, I think, would have worked. I think that was a pretty, or what seemed like a pretty easy edge guard. Aldo dropping it a little bit. But. Yes, yeah, so Ferber taking first stock. A dead Puff off the top. A lot of percent, though. That's gonna be a equally dead Fox. Just wrong roll. Back air, up tilt back air. Like, that's happened a couple times these last couple sets by Fergren. It's always like 40%+. It's a really great combo, percent-wise. Goes in. Fakes the jab, checks the space, comes back in with an up smash. Pretty classic and pretty smart. Dropping that one a little bit, I think, too. Could have been a reaction to that side B. Shield pokes the foot. Never fun, but you gotta shield the eye there. It's not gonna work. Gets that up here. It's always hard to follow a Puff that DI as well, but covering the ground enough to get there. Ferber kind of ran away with this, like, under the radar. Didn't really seem like it was such a dominant performance, but he's definitely a huge lead. But that could easily go away. Puff always has that. One kill and a rest. But not if, not if Aldo dies right here. It. So, Ferber taking game one. Not a dreamland. Pretty reasonable counter pick. I put this in. So while I'm doing the score and stuff, Aldo starts off the game with a rest, taking the lead. And now Joel's trying to laser, it seems, play a little more cautious. Good back there, trying to mix up the DI. That's a good little trick that can get a stock every now and then for a Fox. Nothing too major, but maybe a stock every couple sets and it adds up. Same trick again. Jab to threaten the space, move back, move in, up smash. Maybe that's a good thing against Puff. I don't know, but it's working well, and Joel seems to be, like, going out of his way to use it. So I imagine it's a good tool in the matchup. Joel's a Puff man, I'm sure he knows lots of those tricks. Hi-ya! Yeah. Faldo doesn't win this game on Dreamland, it's not looking good. You can take this stock pretty easily, just roll a Gledge. Choco straight at him. I guess he was hoping he'd drop off Ledge to do like a back air or something and he could grab Ledge. Not much of a hope there in a situation like that, but at least that way he had an option. Kind of hesitates a little bit there. Off the reversed back air, probably could have had a lot more. Jab on shield, dash through, up smash. Yeah, these up tilt back air combos are definitely like racking up a lot of percent for Troll. And just a well spaced up smash takes the game. And run back. Aldo taking him right back, I imagine. Pretty much just the best stage for Puff in the matchup, so no reason not to go back. That was some very clean shield pressure, what I will notice. Dash attack was the right move there. Maybe it was, but I have a feeling that a forward smash there could have killed. Just rolls out of that grab. There where Puff's like floating above stage and either has to return to the ledge or the stage. If you just throw out an up smash, you're probably gonna trade. That was really smart by Joel just to put that out there. Crouch cancel. That's tricky. Puff isn't good at dealing with crouch cancel, so I guess just looking to hope we get a up smash off that. Space and just dash dancing. They're both playing cautious. Gets it there though. Wasn't really much to commentate, I felt like. It's interesting how often Joel will do like a up tilt where against other characters you would do a shine. Never really thought that much about it, but as against Puff, that it would be pretty amazing option, especially if you can land behind shield. So you don't get anything off a shine, but you do get something off an up tilt. I think that could have just been an up smash at a shield, but I guess that wouldn't have killed, and the up throw up here might have, so maybe why he went for that. Probably was better for that reason, but up smash definitely would have hit. And that's it. 30 for Joel. What's up? Who are you playing?